Tonight, Baltimore City is facing an historic budget deficit, but Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake has a solution to fix that problem, plus the other problems plaguing city government. 11 News reporter Kate Amara is live tonight at City Hall. She has the very latest for us. Kate?
According to her office, the mayor is working on her budget proposal right now. She is expected to present it at the end of March. And today, she was brutally honest with city residents. Be prepared for some big cuts, including cuts to core services.
Humbled.
In her first State of the City address as mayor, Stephanie Rawlings-Blake focused on the state of Baltimore's economy, a record $120 million budget cap, a deficit that is equal to half the police force, all of the fire department, or a 36% increase in the property tax rate. Even so, the mayor promised to deliver a balanced budget without raising the property tax.
We will consolidate city services and agencies, cut government bureaucracy, create new public-private partnerships, and ensure transparency and ethical conduct. We will ask all of our city employees to do more with less and to make new sacrifices in order to preserve core priorities and keep city government going.
It was blunt talk bolstered by real ideas. Rawlings-Blake vowed to cut crime by investing in crime camera technology and keeping every patrol officer on the streets. She promised better schools as well by funding programs like Teach for America, and she underscored that pledge with a visit to Hamilton Elementary School earlier in the day. The mayor joined Maryland's senior senator for a roundtable discussion on the program, a scene which also showed the support the Rawlings-Blake administration has from the highest levels of government.
When Barbara Mikulski is on your side, it's hard to be against you. So I'm very proud for Teach for America that she's here supporting it.
While she was at that school today, the mayor taped a public service announcement for the census, urging residents to participate. An accurate census count for Baltimore means more federal money coming into the city, a city that in the past has protested and appealed what were considered low census estimates. Reporting live from City Hall, I'm Kate Amara, WBAL-TV 11 News.